Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video of signs and symptoms of a bad engine mount. Engine mounts are a critical component of vehicles and engines, and their function is relatively straightforward. The purpose of an engine mount is not only to keep the engine securely in place, but also to help reduce noise and vibrations in the vehicle and throughout the engine. Engine mounts are typically made of steel for strength and rigidity, and also a rubber or rubber-like material, and that's what actually helps reduce vibrations and noises throughout the engine, the chassis and vehicle in general. However, they are prone to wear and tear, especially because they are made of rubber or rubber-like materials. Over time, those materials can simply degrade and begin wearing down. So motor mounts, or also known as engine mounts, are something to be on the lookout for as a potential issue on older vehicles, especially once you near that 10-year mark and 100,000 plus miles. That's typically a time frame where engine mounts can start to go bad. Anyway, with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a failing engine mount. So number one on the list, we have excessive vibrations. This is pretty straightforward. As I mentioned, the purpose of engine mounts is not only to keep the engine securely in place, but also reduce those noises and vibrations. And that's why there is rubber in the engine mount. When the engine mount begins failing, the rubber and materials that make up the engine mount can no longer properly absorb those vibrations. And so ultimately that leads to excessive vibrations that you can feel in the vehicle. And that's especially true in the case of the steering wheel. Often any vibrations in a vehicle are very easy to notice in the steering wheel. So if your car is continually getting worse vibrations in the vehicle and through the steering wheel, then a bad engine mount is a very possible cause of that. Moving on to symptom number two, we have excessive noises. Again, this is much like the first topic with vibrations. Engine mounts are there to help reduce noise as well. If you have excess vibration, you're also going to get excess noise from that. And so you might just hear a little extra noise coming from the engine bay. And another sound that you might pick up on is clunking or rattling. And the reason for that is these engine mounts are designed to keep the engine securely in place. When they start failing, that will allow the engine to move more. And that's ultimately in part what leads to the vibrations and noises. When it comes to a clunking or rattling sound, what can happen is if engine mount failure gets bad enough, the engine can actually start hitting other components within the engine bay. As it's allowed to move side to side or front to back, it can actually start contacting other components. So that's why it is important to fix motor mounts in a timely manner, because if it gets bad enough, that can start causing issues with other things, like the engine knocking into other components, or even just squishing or stretching out plastic hoses, electrical components, all sorts of different things. Moving on to symptom number three, excessive jerking on startup, shutdown, or heavy acceleration. So engines tend to move the most when they're subjected to significant changes in torque being sent to the engine. And so that often happens on startup, engine shutdown, or again, hard acceleration. And then again, when you let off the accelerator, the engine, as that torque falls off, is going to tend to move a lot. Last but not least on the list, symptom number four is visual wear and tear or damage to the engine mounts. Now this one's pretty straightforward. Again, the rubber and rubber-like materials that make up the engine mounts, as that begins wearing down and degrading, you can typically notice visually that that is wearing down and potentially failing. Now, depending on the engine and the model vehicle you have, the engine mounts may be easy to see or they may be a lot tougher to see. But if you are able to easily visually inspect the motor mounts, that can be a good way to tell if they are failing and going bad, just by a quick, simple visual inspection to see how everything looks and if there is potentially any damage to the rubber or rubber-like materials surrounding the engine mount. So that really wraps up the most common signs and symptoms of engine mounts. Again, the biggest two are going to be the excessive noise and vibrations, as that's one thing that the motor mounts are largely responsible for, is reducing that noise and vibration. Now, in terms of common causes of engine mount failure, there are really only a couple things that tend to cause engine mount failure. One of them is just age and natural wear and tear. Even without a ton of mileage, age can take a toll on rubber or any other rubber-like materials. Age can simply wear down and just degrade that material and cause the motor mounts to go bad. And the other thing to be on the lookout for is any fluid leaks onto the engine mounts can cause them to go bad, oil and fuel will start eating away at the rubber and cause the motor mounts to fail. So those are really the two most common causes of failure. Now, when it comes to replacing the engine mount, again, the engine mounts actually support the engine and help keep it securely in place. So to replace them, you will actually have to support the engine with an engine support bar or support brace. And so if you don't have one of those, that is something that you'll need to pick up if you plan on DIYing this job. It is generally a pretty simple repair. However, it can vary widely depending on the vehicle, make, year, model, and what engine you have. Sometimes it's pretty simple, and other times it may require removing parts of the subframe or other things within the engine bay. If you find yourself at a repair shop, the engine mounts tend to cost about $20 to $150 each, and you'll likely end up spending about $200 to $600 in labor. So it can add up if you end up going to a repair shop for the job. Now, as one final note to wrap up the video, it does depend on the vehicle and engine. Not every engine uses the same amount of engine mounts. However, it's pretty common for most vehicles to have two or three of them. And if they're failing due to old age and just natural wear and tear, you might consider replacing all of the engine mounts, since once you're actually in there doing the work. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.